previously on the Budgeteers. After arriving in LA, we decided to hitchhike across the desert to Phoenix, Arizona, where the plan was to couch surf there before heading over to Mexico. Unfortunately for us, I had an anxiety attack, and we had to get rescued by a 19-year-old fan of the show in the form of Casey. It's fair to say we failed big time, but we did eventually make it to the border of Mexico, where the plan was simple. We wanted to hang out in Tijuana for a few days, then spend a few days hitchhiking down the Baja Peninsula, where we could catch a ferry from La Paz to the mainland and continue hitchhiking to the border of Guatemala.
All right, rolling?
Rolling.
Cool.
Llegamos!
What's up?
Hey!
Welcome back to the Budgeteers, episode 2. Right now we're here in Tijuana, Mexico.
Viva Tijuana,
Mexico!
Last time we just crossed the border, California showed us a lot of love. We spent $500 of our $1,000 each budget. So yeah, we need to start saving the pennies. We're in quite an interesting place.
Yeah.
The border town, there's lots of characters here already. We're about to get picked up by our
couchsurfing host, Antonio.
Yeah.
So, let's do this.
Let's do this shit.
Mexico.
Vamos.
All right, so first problem that we ran into is we just crossed the border. Our couchsurfing host, Antonio, told us just to call him and he'll come and pick us up because he lives real close, but
the phone doesn't work here.
Yeah, we try and call it, nothing's working. So ask a local, maybe? Let's just go over here and ask this lady. We can borrow a phone and we can call the guy.
Hola, Antonio, es Lina. Bien, ¿y tú? Mira, acabamos de llegar, estamos ya entramos e hicimos todo, acabamos de salir, estamos aquí donde entran los taxis.
Cheers, Lina, high five on that one. What did he say? So there's a car crash, but no one seems to care. Do we have to go to the place he told us to pick us up?
Probably.
Yeah, it's okay. It's down that way.
We're now looking for our couchsurfing host, who is friendly enough to come and pick us up. We asked these lovely locals that passed on the street for help, and they called our host, and now they're guiding us to the place where he'll be. Hey, hello, man.
How you doing?
Good.
Yeah.
Safety belt, please.
Yep. We found him.
Yeah.
Yes.
Well, he found us.
Okay.
So as soon as we came over the border, somebody was like, put your camera away, put your camera away.
Yeah, it's dangerous to run around with
not exactly. No, no. This is not an unsafe area. I work in this street.
Okay.
So right now, our host Antonio took us to a local food truck, and we're gonna test a few things out here, a few tacos, which is really good apparently.
Meanwhile, speaking Spanish. Okay, this food truck is next level. Antonio, thank you for bringing us here, man. See, this is the best thing about couchsurfing. They bring you to all these amazing places that are super cheap, super delicious. Fresh tacos, shrimps, avocados, cabbage, tomatoes. Wash it down with an azaca.
Horchata.
Horchata, which is rice, water, cinnamon, vanilla. So this is spicy, this is cool and cools your mouth down. Like, all for like a few dollars, man. Look at this place, this is next level.
Delicious.
Delicious.
Delicioso.
Delicioso. Delicioso. Alright, get it down, yeah.
After eating way too many tacos, Antonio dropped us off at the Cultural Museum of Tijuana while he went back to work for a few hours. Later that afternoon, we made our way back to his apartment where he surprised us with tickets to go see the local baseball team, the Tijuana Toros.
So here we are, we're in up in the mountains in Tijuana. Our host Antonio gave me this nice baseball jersey. You gotta be careful you don't get run over here. I love Mexico so much more than California already. No offense. It's got way loads of stuff happening around you. People here are cool, but everyone's just hanging out in their garden. It's just a good vibe here, man. Taz, what do you reckon?
Whew. This is cool.
Hey Antonio, who's this?
Cesar.
You guys met in Florence?
Yes, we met in Florence.
Long time ago.
14.
It's a small world, huh?
12 years ago.
So Tijuana gonna win or what?
Yeah, hopefully.
Well, I live here. He lives in San Diego, but I host people for free by plate. They come here.
It's a summer beer.
Who's taller between you two? That's what I want to know.
No, he's taller than me. He's taller than me.
I'm still win.
Yeah, you're still winning.
In Belgium, you'd beat my time.
Mexico in Spanish. Wish me luck.
I'm here just to mediate.
¿Cuánto es una?
25.
¿Cuánto es tu ley?
50.
All right, so at the Mexican baseball, beers come this big. And they rim the outside with chili flakes and chili sauce. So let me try this shit. This is weird. You want to try it as well? Mmm. Yummy. By the way, Mexico is amazing.
One thing's for sure, Mexicans know how to have a good time. The atmosphere was amazing, and we were just taking it all in. After the game, Antonio took us to a taqueria for a late night snack. And fair to say, we had yet another feast. The next few days, we spent chilling and relaxing at the house and doing some typical backpacker stuff, like doing laundry, some workouts, and exploring the local markets and attractions of Tijuana.
Let the quality speak to you.
To be honest, we could fill an entire episode on just Tijuana, or TJ as the locals call it. Because this place is just so alive, and there's just so much to do here. The Mexican culture, the lively people, the fascinating history, and of course, the tasty food were some of the best we've seen anywhere in the world, and we can't recommend Tijuana enough. The highlight for us had to be going back to the baseball a second night to watch the Toros win the semi-final. So of course, we had to celebrate with even more beers this time and a few tequilas. And we danced the night away with Antonio and his crazy group of friends. The final day with Antonio, he had something special planned for us. He had invited us to come and visit the vineyards of Guadalupe to celebrate his friend Elizabeth's birthday.
Happy birthday.
Thank you.
Él se quiere ir aquí enfrente para ir grabando.
Sí, para que vayan grabando. Come here, Patty.
Patty Boos.
Where are we going?
Guaymas. Guadalupe.
We're going to Guaymas.
Guaymas.
Lo más bonito es
San Diego es Tijuana.
The short drive to Valle Guadalupe was the beginning of our journey down the Baja Peninsula. But first, we had to celebrate Andy's birthday. How? Did somebody say wine? Yep, wine. And a vineyard. And more wine. And even more wine. A little bit of cheese. And another vineyard. It was honestly one of the best days of the entire trip, all thanks to Antonio and all of his friends. Luckily, our next host Sylvia lived close by and she kindly agreed to come pick us up. And just like that, we were off on the next part of our big adventure.
I'm Patty.
Patty?
Patty, yeah.
Okay, Sylvia.
escucháis. Ah, mucho gusto. Hola, chicos.
Hola.
¿Ustedes?
Elliot.
Silvia, mucho gusto.
Eli.
Mucho gusto,
Silvia.
Pero son gigantes.
Sí, son gigantes.
Rasta, él es Rasta.
Ella es Tom.
Cuídense mucho. Take care.
Oh, I gotta get my bag quickly.
Yes, you're
yes,
stop.
Eso es importante.
Sí.
See you in some place. Cuídense mucho, ¿eh?
Sí, lo mismo.
Yeah, you too.
Let's go, Budgeteers!
We had a cool surfer last night, the Friday to Saturday. Mm-hmm. But we decided, like, oh, you can stay. We're going to San Diego. Maybe come back at the 9 or tomorrow. And they would, it was fun. She's from Colombia. Mm-hmm. And you're from Australia?
No.
England and?
Belgica.
I've been in London.
It's, yeah?
Oh yeah, I love it. I love the place.
I think this is couch surfing first, isn't it, for us? We got dropped off by Antonio, and our new host has just come and picked us up. And we're on some beautiful place called San Miguel, which is a surfer town. The views here
see
look
the
amazing.
Ocean right there.
Yeah, the views look amazing. The ocean's right here. The sun is setting. Look at the size of their dogs.
The dogs are showing us the way.
Hello.
How are
you? Nice to meet you, buddy.
Nice to meet you.
Hello, nice to meet you.
Anwar.
Nice.
You have a rock climbing wall.
Whoa.
In your living room.
That is awesome.
Oh, this is a little
bit. Wow. We met in Australia, we met in Thailand, now we're all together in Mexico.
We met in Los Angeles.
And who thought we would be here right now?
You're doing $1,000 the whole. Until which part?
But just like,
hopefully we don't know where we'll end up,
maybe,
but we'll try to get as far as we can.
Okay, as far as you can.
It was a real shame we only got to stay one night with Anwar and Sylvia, but we really had to get a move on hitchhiking down the Baja Peninsula. That night they cooked us some delicious food and we just hung out at their beautiful home. They were even kind enough the next morning to drop us at a really good hitchhiking spot where we grabbed some breakfast and we just got ready to get back on the road. Good morning! Hey. Here we are in Ensenada.
Almost!
Oh, close.
Ensenada. Name of the game today is let's hitch as far as we can for the next 2 or 3 days and try and get to the bottom of this peninsula.
Apparently, if you're driving straight, it's 16 hours.
Yeah, we're gonna try and get as far as we can today and just keep going because Mexico is bigger than Central America, so it's gonna take us a long time to get through. And we've been going very, very slowly, which has been nice, actually.
Yeah.
But now we're changing pace. It's early as well, so we've got the whole day.
Yeah.
So, yeah,
let's do it.
Let's do it.
Let's do it.
And so we did it. We actually got off to a pretty slow start that morning, but with a little bit of luck and a lot of help from the locals, we eventually started making some distance down the Baja Peninsula.
We're now in San Quintin, right? Yeah.
Somewhere in a dusty, dusty desert anyway.
So we got picked up by a guy named Tiguan. He was freaking awesome. I got to sit up front with him and these guys sat in the back of the truck.
He's taking us all the way where we want to go, which is about halfway down the peninsula. High five that shit.
Woo. And he brought us all the way here, even though it was 30 minutes out of his way.
Was it?
Yeah. We ran into some trouble. We got stopped by the police. It is illegal. I don't know if it's illegal, but they don't.
Illegal.
It must be illegal. Well, we went down some windy roads, so they said that it's not really allowed for people to be in the back of the trucks. But he talked to the police, and they figured it out, and we got to keep going. So now here we are,
yeah.
3 hours later, so it's good.
It's a good example of how up and down the emotions of hitchhiking can be. You get demotivated, you feel like, what the fuck are we doing? And then just as soon as someone comes and picks you up, you just feel elated again. life's great,
yeah.
You're hitchhiking, we were on the top of the truck, this is a loving life, and then the next minute we're stopped by the police.
So now we're here and we're trying to hitch a ride to Guerrero Negro, which is I think 2 or 3 hours south of here. So let's try.
Vamanos.
Our next ride was with a local car mechanic called Victor. He took us a few more hours south through the desert. However, he explained that Guerrero Negro was at least 6 more hours away. So, he kindly offered us to stay and spend the night at his place.
This is what hitchhiking is all about. Stressing out because you're not getting picked up. Next minute, you're having a beer on a veranda overlooking this beautiful scenery. And everything's good again.
Oh yes, we're having a beer on the veranda.
Afterwards, he took us for dinner at a local trucker stop, where they had an all-you-can-eat menu. As you can imagine, we all went crazy inside of all that delicious food. I must have destroyed 4 or 5 plates with the most spiciest chilies any of us had ever tasted. Victor was a true gentleman. And even though he didn't speak a word of English, through Lena's translation, we spent a great evening together.
Good morning. It's pretty early in the morning right now. This is Victor's place. Now we're hitchhiking out really early in the morning, and we're gonna walk up to the main road. Thanks again, Victor, for lending out your house. We have to kind of like sneak out in the morning now, because he's not awake yet and we want to have an early start today because we're hitchhiking to Guerrero Negro, which is about
forever away.
Yeah, 4 to 6 hours of driving. So it's a long, long, long way to go.
That morning's hitch went really well, to be fair, and we managed to get picked up quite quickly by an American guy called Brick.
Have a nice day. Safe journey.
And then we got picked up by a great group of Mexican guys.
Me llamo.
Me llamo Paddy.
¿De qué parte de Guerrero es él?
Lina. Tolamo.
Él se llama. Se llama. No, ella. Se llama.
Lina. Se llama.
And then finally, after a really long day of hitchhiking, we got picked up by another American. But for some reason, he pulled over in the middle of nowhere and basically left us stranded in the boiling hot desert heat. Welcome back. I think we're officially breaking records here. For the longest time we've had to wait for a ride
car.
In the history of the Budgeteers. So basically this is the situation. Tizer's on this rock looking for cars.
No cars.
Is he pulling over? Ah, oh, dude. He had dreadlocks and everything. But yeah, there's a car coming like one every 10-20 minutes. And we're in the middle of the desert, man. You think people would stop? Come on, Lena. This is all your fault. How long have we been waiting for? All right. 2 hours? 2 hours. Soon we're gonna have to figure out what we're gonna do if we don't get picked up because we're in the middle of the desert. We got picked up, we're in the back of a truck, everything's going fine.
We just saw the most amazing landscapes in this desert. It's so beautiful.
We ran out of SD cards. This one we've salvaged from a GoPro.
Yeah.
Basically, we're hitchhiking towards a hurricane. He's told us that the roads might have all been destroyed.
The military has been deployed and they're closing down roads farther up ahead. We don't know how far we're gonna get, so this is all guesswork right now.
He's taking us so far, so we're about halfway down the peninsula of Mexico.
Hello, Jose.
Hello.
Okay, so yesterday we were hitchhiking in his town where he lives, and
we were at the gas station and he drove by with his daughter and they saw us. And she wanted him to pick us up because she thought these two back here were little Rico Suaves. And then today when he went, when he left for his journey, he was a few hours in and he saw us on the side of the road and picked us up. Fucking rock and roll, Mexico!
When she says Rico Suave, that means handsome.
Yeah, or looks at all the work.
Vamos a la hurricane.
Al huracán.
Al huracán. Huracán, ¿cómo se llama?
As the night progressed, the hurricane gained power, and our driver, Jose, was so worried for our safety that he pulled over into a roadside motel and paid for all of us to take shelter from the impending hurricane. It wasn't until the next day, when we hitchhiked further south into Santa Rosalia, that we finally saw the extent of the damage.
So this is like one of the most destroyed parts of this town. All this area here is where the main town sort of like square was, leading out to the pier. There's cars covered in rocks, there's a Jeep Cherokee completely surrounded, people trying to dig it out. You can see cars in the distance that have been thrown out, washed away into the sea. And people are just trying to clear it up as best they can.
Since the roads leading south to La Paz were still closed for 24 hours, we decided to walk around town and see if we could find a place to stay and ask any of the locals if they needed any help. But since the government had responded very quickly, there was already plenty of professional help on hand. The next day, we jumped in with a local guy called Polo. He was driving to La Paz and he had offered us a free ride. The journey was long and cramped, and we could see more evidence of the damage that the hurricane had caused. Eventually, after 10 hours of slow progress, we made it to the outskirts of La Paz, where we had to find our next couchsurfing host. All we knew was he was a marine biologist and that his name was Eric.
It's always good when you arrive in a town during the day, because when you get to a town at night, you don't really know where you are, you don't feel comfortable. We're out of the desert heat, but we're into the humidity heat. We've crossed from the other side of the peninsula, where it's the Pacific Ocean, to this side, which is the Sea of Cortez, I think. And so it's really hot here. It feels like we're in Thailand or in the Mediterranean. I think we're just gonna catch the sunset as well, which is a good thing. Yeah, we missed the sunset. It's just gone behind the mountain.
It's arrived, wasn't it?
We just missed it as well.
Okay, that makes
us feel better. Behind the mountain.
Makes us feel better.
We made it to La Paz.
Eric's here.
Hi.
Eric. Say hello, YouTube.
Hello, Budgeteers.
Yeah, let's go.
We made it.
Food.
Made it, right? Food.
Eric, my man.
Where?
What are you doing?
I'm doing ham and eggs.
That's very good English.
Ham and eggs, I want to make potato with tomato, onions, and chili. Very great.
Not bad, huh?
Frijoles. Mexican frijoles.
I'm learning Spanish with this app. Right now, I'm 2% fluent in Spanish, so
that's not too bad. I'm about 25% fluent. Hola, muy bien, gracias.
Muy bien, gracias. Muy bien, gracias. Mucho gusto. My name is Potato. Potato is my name.
Ask me a question in Spanish, and I'll see if I can answer it.
¿Por qué eres tan feo?
Sigue todo recto a la derecha.
Ah, okay.
See, I know what I'm talking about. Guys, what happened last night then?
We went out with Eric's friends, yeah. And we had the best time dancing.
Yeah,
we were killing it on that dance floor.
Oh yeah.
She was in love with some of my friends.
All of them.
Yes.
Sure.
We tucked into Eric's delicious breakfast and chilled out for a few hours.
Did you see your dog? Yes.
Hello.
Gaia.
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 This is Gaia.
And you rescued her.
She
just came up to the house one day. And you fell in love with her straight away, huh?
Yes.
Who couldn't?
If you scratch her here, she does this weird thing with her leg. Watch.
Lena went to book our ferry tickets, and it turns out that I misread the website. And apparently, not only do the ferries not run every day, but they also are super expensive.
We can't get a ferry until Sunday.
Today's Friday. There's a ferry today.
No, there isn't.
The guys took it pretty well, but I knew that I had messed up our plans once again.
I don't think it's bad, I just think you're an idiot.
Well, I'm sorry, I don't speak Spanish.
No, but you're traveling with someone who does.
It's like a year in here, right?
Yoda!
Luckily, before we could get too down in the dumps, Eric came up with a really cool idea, and he took us to what Mexico calls as its most beautiful beach.
Well, if you ever need another excuse to try couch surfing, it's this one. Eric's like, hey, in La Paz they have this beach, it's known as the most beautiful beach in Mexico, and in my experience, anytime you hear the most beautiful beach in this country, it's always a letdown, there's always tourists. And sure enough, we get to the beach, it's kind of like the main part where the car park is, and there's tourists there, there's people selling tourist tat. So our boy Eric, the local, says, no, trust me, we'll walk around, we'll go over some rocks, we'll walk around a cave, and we'll have our own little section here. Now there is a couple of people swimming, we must have come around earlier, there's a guy who canoed over here. We've got our own little spot, they're putting up a marquee, the dog's having the time of his life. And yeah, I think we're going to have a day at the beach, just snorkeling and having fun. And again, this wouldn't have happened if you don't know a local and staying with a couch surfer. So, Eric, you're a legend.
Can you tell everyone why you're being a pissy waiter? Basically, there were ferries every day to Mexico.
No, it's not that.
No, espera. Also, they're much more expensive than we thought they were gonna be. So we've just spent
$237
on plane tickets.
Basically, in a nutshell, what happened was overnight ferries in Thailand and Asia are like pennies. So I thought it would cost us $20 max each. They're more like $80 each. And the ferry goes to Mazatlan, which is that really dangerous town that we've been told not to go to, right?
We don't think Mexico is dangerous, mm-hmm. but people have told us to not really, they're like, don't stay around that area. That's probably like the not so good area of Mexico.
Basically, we always follow what the locals say, and the locals have told us on our travels so far, be careful of this area. This area that the ferry gets into is a bit dodgy, and if Mexican people are telling you that this part of Mexico is not good, then we shouldn't really hitchhike on the side of the street there. I fucked up.
Why did you fuck up?
Because I said let's go down and get the ferry. It'll take a couple of days and we'll have a fun time on the ferry. It took us 4 days to get here. The ferry is ridiculously expensive. Now we have to fly.
We have 60% left of our money and we've been here 16 days. I'm really glad Lena's taken this seriously. I'm gonna go eat some fruit.
You were the one who told me, Lena, this isn't about, you know, not spending money. It's just about having fun until your money runs out.
Don't worry, we kissed and made up and then enjoyed a few more days in paradise. On our last full day in La Paz, we were invited to a barbecue. And of course we said yes, because tacos.
Welcome to a Mexican barbecue.
Budgeteers hard at work. Again. Tortilla, sausage, cactus, spicy guacamole. This is how they do food in the Mexican barbecue.
It's 2 o'clock in the morning right now. Lena's here.
Hola!
Adios. Eric is here. The DJ.
We are in a street in Baja.
We have a saying in Baja.
In Baja. Ah, so fucking beautiful. No. We are in Baja. Nobody's in Baja.
So yeah, our couch-surfing host Eric is a little bit worse for wear after this cool party.
Tomorrow, my best couch-surfing ever, I'm going to float like to Guadalajara.
Oh my God.
But I really like it because I really love it.
You fucking pisshead.
You are the best host. No, you're the best couch surfing ever.
Be really careful. Whenever in Mexico we get drink or drunk, we get touchy.
Really? Really? Let's go. Yeah.
The next day, it's fair to say that we were all a little bit worse for wear. Danny, who was at the party, had taken us all in as we were all way too drunk to get back to Eric's. She was amazingly cool and she cooked us a huge breakfast. Then we headed back to Eric's to get our stuff and say goodbye. But not before he gave us a really cool going away present.
Best couch surfers ever. I'm gonna give you this, Budgeteers. This is DNA of a shark. And I'm gonna give you because I'm a scientist, I'm a marine biologist, and I really love working with sharks and with genetics. And this is for you guys.
Now one day, I can make a human shark baby.
And then it was time to go to the airport and leave beautiful Baja behind and start our adventure on the mainland of Mexico.